In this video, we will write the same program from the previous part, just in a different language. The C program got compiled by a compiler into machine code that can be executed directly. Python, on the other hand, is an interpreted language. To understand the difference, I try to make an abstract example. You can imagine a program written in C as a machine built for a very specific task. And Python itself is such a machine written in C, but it's a special machine, like a robot if you want, which is built to interpret different language of code, Python code. So in a trivialized sense, somebody wrote a C code in a file python.c, then used GCC like in the previous video to compile the source code into a binary with the name Python. You can see that when you use the tool file to display file information. When you use file on our C program matrix from last time, it says it's an ELF executable. And when you do the same for the Python program, it also says that it's an ELF executable. Now when you execute the Python program, you will get a prompt where you can enter text and Python will interpret the text for you. Or just pass multiple commands in a Python script and it will execute it. I hope that makes a little bit more sense now. So let's create a new Python script called matrix.py. Alongside, we will also open our previous code to compare it. We can do that with Vim by specifying both file names with a minus capital O. This tells Vim to open the files split vertically. Now check if the cursor is in the correct document. If not, you can use Ctrl W and then arrow left or right to switch between the views. Now enter the insert mode by pressing I and let's get started. In Python, we don't have to specify a main function. The code will be just executed sequentially from the start of the file to the end. To access the command line argument argv, we have to import a Python module called sys. With print sys.argv, we can print the content of this variable. So let's see how this sys.argv variable looks like. First, we save the file with escape colon w. Then you can use colon exclamation mark to execute a command, for example ls. You will see that the editor disappeared into the background and it displays the result of the ls command. So let's use that to execute our Python program. Go back by pressing enter. Colon exclamation mark Python to start Python, and as a first argument we specify the script name, which is matrix.py. Instead of writing the name, you can also just use percentage. Vim will automatically replace the percentage sign with the current file name. You can now see that the first argument was matrix.py. Like I explained in the last video, the arguments passed to the program start with the program file name. Now let's add a few arbitrary arguments. A normal one, one with quotes, one with spaces, and just a couple of more words. Maybe even with more spaces in between them, just to see what happens. Okay, so here's the output. So the brackets indicate that it's a list, and the elements are comma separated, and each element is a string, starting with the file name and the stuff we placed afterwards. I hope that makes command line arguments a bit more clearer. Okay, now to the check if we have two arguments. We don't need a counter of arguments like argc. We can just check if the length of the sysargv list is equal to 2. Note that Python doesn't use curly braces to define a context, like in C. We have to use indentation. When I press tab, I get tabs, which is ugly. I prefer everything to be filled with simple spaces. So you can use set expand tab with shift width equal to 4, soft tab stop equal to 4. Now we get 4 spaces when we press tab. So let's print the first argument. With print and Python special format string syntax, we can exactly do the same like we did in C. Inside the string with curly braces, we define which following format string parameter shall be placed there, and we start counting with 0. And obviously our first format parameter will be the second item of the argv list. Now we do the else case. And to print to standard error, we have to access standard error directly through the sys module. So sys.standardError.write, and then again the usage expression with the curly braces with a 0 to indicate that here should be the first parameter. And the first format variable is the first element of the argvlist, which is the file name. Note that the simple print doesn't need the backslash n for a new line, but the write needs it. That's because Python says that printing with a new line at the end is pretty common, so let's do that automatically for every print. But if you use a bit more low-level access function, then we have to edit ourselves. Also, the fact that we use write to output text should pique your curiosity. Sounds like writing to a file. Well, everything is a file, as you may remember from the Linux introduction video, so keep that in mind when we talk about this a little bit later. Okay, looks done. Let's test it. Save it and quit Vim. To fully close Vim, you obviously have to close two views, so you have to do the colon Q two times. Now execute the matrix.py with python matrix.py, and it works, just like our C program. If you don't want to type Python before your Python script all the time, we can do something about that. Open the script again and create a new line above the import. Remember how you can press O instead of I to enter the insert mode, which creates a new empty line below your cursor. Guess what happens when you use Shift O? It creates a new empty line above your cursor and enters insert mode. Now add shebang with the path to the Python binary. There's also a nice Wikipedia entry about shebang, so check that out. This line tells the program loader that this is a script that should be executed with Python. So it basically does Python matrix.py for us. Now we can execute it like our C program by using the path to the Python script. Oh, permission deny? Why is that? Let's have a look at the permissions. ls-la to display all files along with their permissions, but also use matrix star. This basically means that it should display all files that start with matrix and anything can then follow. When we compare our matrix binary with the matrix Python script, we notice that it has a couple of x. X stands for executable, but our file only has r and w, which stands for read and write permissions. So to be allowed to execute it, we have to add the execution permissions to that file. We can use chmod for that, which stands for change mode bits for a file. Remember to always check out the man page to learn more about those commands. So now we can use chmod plus x and the file name to add the execution permissions. When we now list the files, we can see that we have this x permission. But before we continue, let me quickly talk about the tab completion. I mentioned this in the very first video briefly, but maybe it's a good moment to talk about it a bit more. Tab completion is extremely handy. For example, when I start typing the current path with dot dash and hit tab twice, it shows me all possible files that could follow. So we want matrix, so let's just type one letter M and hit tab again. Now it will automatically fill in matrix. Because there are multiple matrix files, it has stopped at the part where they start to differ. Double tap to display all the options. Now add a dot, which makes the only available option left matrix.py. Tap again, and we got the whole file name. I use Python a lot. Almost anything I program, I write in Python. So most of my examples will be written in Python, and it's also a language I highly recommend to learn in general. So maybe check out Code Academy's Python courses or just Google yourself. Before we finish, let's keep our system updated. Type sudo apt-get update to update the package list from the repository. And then apt-get upgrade to install new versions for software you have installed. This may take a while if you haven't never done it or haven't done it in a while. You should always keep your system up to date, and you should preach that to your family members. Even if they are annoyed at the Windows update, make sure that the systems are always up to date.